getting ready to go live here on American Warrior
Welcome
Radio.
Welcome to another exciting edition of American Warrior Radio. This is a special one because we're coming to you from the Tico Warbird Airshow here in Titusville. Glenn, this is a phenomenal setting. We've been doing this for years.
This is outstanding, and that noise you hear in the background comes from a babble zone.
That's right. Lots of static displays and activities, car shows, and obviously every type of flying aircraft you can imagine, including helicopters. Look, folks, American Warrior Radio is the place to be for news, notes, and air events for all agents, military and veteran related. If you or someone you know, and I'm talking fast because we've got a jam-packed program. Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, Coast Guard, or National Guard or Reserves, you've come to the right place. American Warrior Radio, right here on the Talk to Me station, AM 1060 WMEL, and online worldwide at 1060WMEL.com, sponsored by AVET Project. Folks, you all know this program is about supporting our troops and their families, both past and present, so please get comfortable, grab a pen and paper, because we always are efforting to bring you important information that you can use and share with others. So with that said, let's roll down the runway here at the Tico Warbird Air Show and get this show off the ground. Y'all know me, I'm Garen Cohn. I'm an Air Force veteran, a retired legal advocate for veterans, and founder of AVET Project. But you also know I'm out here at the Tico Warbird Air Show, and I am not flying through the airwaves alone.
Good morning, I'm Bill McGuffey. I'm retired Air Force, and I'm the retired manager of the Brevard County Veteran Services team. It's my honor to help our veterans develop independent, gain benefits, earn through the veteran service of our great nation. And I've been able to do that for 22 years. And you can contact me now if you think you need some help with a VA claims issue at Glenn, GLEN. AVET Project, AVETPROJECT.org. So we're going to roll down the runway as Garrett says. We've got a jam-packed show for you today. And take her away, Garrett. A
couple quick announcements. Kids on the Water. This is an outreach program of AVET Project to invite the children and their family members to get out of the house, get away from the TV and the video games. April 2nd, you don't want to miss it at Wickham Park, Front Lake at Wickham Park. I want you to go to our social media pages and the website, avetproject.org, to find out more. Got a load of kids already registered, but there's always room for more. So check it out, KOTW, Kids on the Water, coming up on April 2nd. Go to the website to find that out. Hey, help us help them, meaning our military family. We have a pre-deployment dinner for the 1/124th Infantry Regiment as they set to deploy for their fourth deployment plan. Fourth.
Yeah, and they're, if you're not familiar, they're out of Cocoa with the Army.
Exactly. There's a stand down coming just in another week or so, but that same unit that is housed there is going over to protect our freedoms again. And we're going to give them a pre-deployment dinner here at AVET Project. So help us help them. Whether you can contribute by making a donation, maybe you want to volunteer, maybe you just want to come out and deliver some food or something like that, get a hold of us. Go to avetproject.org, click on the contact button, and you'll get through to us. Also want to make a quick mention that the Jewish Federation of Brevard is holding their incredible annual event. It's against all odds. This is where the Jewish Federation of Brevard, which is sponsored by VITAS this year, is conducting their big annual fundraiser. There's so many events going on. We're happy that AVET Project is a beneficiary of this event. Melbourne Auditorium tomorrow from 11 to 6. So you don't want to miss that. Information is online as well. Glenn, we got to talk real quick about where we're at and what's going on here at the Tico Warbird Air Show.
Well, today we've got about 40 minutes to get out here and see the Warbird.
Well, we've got the flight line is going to be opening here soon. Okay, you can see all of the static displays and the cars and what have you, but the actual air show is going to start taking place when, Glenn?
Yep, from 1 to 4:30, so you've got plenty of time to get out of here and watch these magnificent men and their flying machines.
We, AVET Project and American Warrior Radio, has been doing this out of the air show for a long time now. And thanks to WMEL and John Harper, it's always a fun event. We welcome you to come out here to our booth, which is just, I'm guessing, if I got my directions right, just west of the information booth. You can't miss us. Look for the big AM 1060 WMEL banner and American Warrior Radio. Stop by and say hello. We're out here for your benefit. We're broadcasting throughout our huge 50,000 watt terrestrial radio signal reach. But we're also online, and we're here live with this live remote thanks to our distributor, John O'Hara. Glenn, what are some of the
Saddle Forces Fifi that my father-in-law flew during World War II. He's still around with us.
Well, he drove it down the taxiway before he took off.
Well, he did. We've got F-16 Fighting Falcon demonstration.
And we're going to have that pilot, or one of the pilots, come by here in the second segment to say hello.
Great. And we got a Marine Corps FA-18 Super Hornet demonstration, aeroshell demonstration team, MiG-7.
And that aeroshell, let me say real quick, those are T-6 Texans, and they are awesome looking. I have never seen a demonstration team with the A-6 Texan, but that's going to be awesome.
It is really awesome.
Very powerful airplanes.
And we've got Matt Youngkin and his Beach-18, a B-25 Mitchell, F-86 Sabre. That's back from my days. F-51D, the Rebel, Christian Eagle, Butler, Triplane.
The list goes on and on. I mean, honestly, we've got the Corsairs and the Tico Bell. That's a special one that they refurbished here.
Yeah.
At the Valiant Air Command. I want to encourage everybody, the air show is going on today and tomorrow. It was a phenomenal time last night. We're actually going to have Ron Davis stop by and speak with us about the success of last night. The air show is going on throughout today and tomorrow. You don't want to miss it. There's so much. I mean, honestly, Glenn, that list just goes on and on and on.
I know. And, you need to get out here and enjoy it. There's all kinds of booths out here. There's stuff for the children. They're flying them for free on the Huey and the Cobra.
Boy, it's an impressive day. You don't want to miss this. So come on out to the Tyco Warburg Air Show. It is their 39th air show, and it just gets better and better every year.
It's awesome. Come on out.
Well, we got to kick this puppy into gear. We got to kick the tires and light the fires because we got a lot of ground to cover. Right now, let me just make a quick mention. Because you have your office hours for AVAP Project and the American Legion Post 200 there in Satellite Beach where people can come and get late.
Correct.
And what's the deal?
Send me an email, we'll get together, or I can easily buy email and help out.
Okay, so we're going to kick it in, people. SCCLS, you've heard us talk about it, Space Coast Community Law School. This is an awesome outreach, primarily for the Perry Anderson Hawkins Law Firm here in Titusville. Britta Hawkins put this puppy together with help from, obviously, other sponsors like the Bar Foundation and WML and American Career Foundation. It's phenomenal. They are free legal seminars on a regular basis. We have, we're privileged to have with us right now, Kristen from Anderson. Hi, Kristen.
Hi, guys. Thank you very much for having me over here. And you are right, American Warrior Radio has been a huge help in promoting our Space Coast Community Law School, so we thank you for that. Our founder, Britta Hawkins, she couldn't be here today, but she has done a great job in pretty much setting up once a year. We have 10 days of seminars, and we are down to our last two. One is coming up March 17th, and we are having a campaign fundraising seminar, and that's going to be presented by a couple of our members of our local bar. We always get local judges and local attorneys to come in and speak, and we're really excited. Actually, this is the first time we're doing it. On March 24th, we're going to have a mock trial, so all of our attendees who spent the last 10 weeks with us learning certain things, we've had a little special project for them, and our local county court judge, David Silverman, is going to be conducting a mock trial. So we encourage everyone to come out, learn something. We try to promote some general knowledge that every community, every household should have a little bit of knowledge on. And that's what we do every year.
Kristen, you are such a natural. I should change the seats with you. You need to buy another one.
Take mine.
Phenomenal. Now, how can people find out or get registered for these last two classes?
You can find us on Facebook, as always, and you can also find us at www.sccls.com. Our firm website for Telfer Verity Anderson & Hawkins also has links to it, and you can find us at legalrightsforyou.com. Numerical form of the interview.
And the next class is coming up this Thursday, and then the following Thursday is the mock trial, which is going to be exciting. Never done that before.
We've never done it before. We've actually assigned some little assignments to some of our attendees who expressed a great interest in it. So they've been practicing for 10 weeks, and it's going to be pretty fantastic. We're excited about it. And really, all you got to do is show up. We do this down in Vieira. We do it at the Ward Justice Center in the jury assembly room on the first floor. So we encourage everyone to pre-register and sign up to let us know that you're coming so we can have material. But please, if you don't, show up. We start at 6 o'clock. We'd love to have everyone out there.
And don't bring metal or knives or anything like that, or you'll get held up.
That's for sure. And a phone number in case somebody doesn't have online access.
You may reach us at the office at 321-269-6833.
Awesome, Kristen. Thank you so much for popping by today. And wait a minute, you've got a booth set up here at the Airshow, too.
We do. We have a booth set up just a few doors down here from Warrior Radio, and we're actually raffling off a gun trust, an NFA gun trust. So for those of you who would like to possess Class 3 weapons and silencers, you are not permitted as an individual to own them, but you are allowed to have a trust owner. So we are raffling them off, and if not, if you don't win,
I think it's important that we do this interview with Lieutenant Colonel Dickinson, U.S. Air Force retired. This gentleman is 100 years young and went with the Air Force, Aaron. Well, he flew with the Air Force, but in particular, Jimmy Doolittle.
Oh, yes.
We can't forget that. Colonel, how are you this morning?
I'm fine, thank you.
Well, we spoke a little bit during the air show last year. I want to thank you for making the time out for us today to come by here on American Warrior Radio. How young are you today?
100 years old.
That's impressive. I mean, I should be so lucky. How about you, Glenn?
I wish.
Well, tell us just real quick. Our audience always has a thirst to find out more about people that have done so much to protect our country, and you're retired Air Force, but tell us a little about this flying with Jimmy Doolittle.
Well, I was very fortunate as a young man to be able to, by chance and good luck, end up being on a crew with Colonel Doolittle. It's one of the big points in my life.
Well, tell us a little bit about the first time you met him and when you flew with him.
The first time I met him was in Columbia, South Carolina, I had been crewed up with another pilot, and he became ill. And Colonel Doolittle came in that particular day, and all he did was take that gentleman's seat. And we were the baggage that went along with him.
Okay, what was the platform? What plane were you flying that day? Do you remember? What plane were you flying that day?
It was a B-25. I don't remember the number.
But a B-25, which was a staple of our effort in the war.
Yes, good, stable, fast airplane.
You liked that airplane?
Yeah. Well, at that time, it was like going from a Model T to a Model...
to a Mustang, Corvette?
To a Mustang.
That's a good analogy. Okay, so you're out here at the Tico Warbird Air Show, and you've been making this every year for a while now. What's the most exciting thing? What's interesting you out here today?
Well, the Raiders have a scholarship program, and we have a lithograph and a book, and offer people for the scholarship program. And it's the James H. Doolittle Scholarship in the Texas communities. It's open to students that are interested in aviation and space. But they have to be between their junior and sophomore year.
To be eligible. Okay, great. Well, Colonel, I want to thank you again for everything you've done for our country, retired Air Force, and also flying with Jimmy Doolittle. It's just amazing that you're out here. Like I said, I should be so lucky. Glenn, anything you want to say?
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
I want to add my congratulations.
Great career. He can't hear you because you're way over there. Plus, it's a little windy out here. Sir, thank you again. That's Lieutenant Colonel Dick Cole with the Doolittle Raiders. We appreciate everything you've done and for being out here and joining us on American Warrior Radio today.
Thank you for your service.
You bet. Thank you, sir. Have a great day. Enjoy the air show. We're just moving right along here. You know, we've got so much ground to cover. Guess what? We've got our special friends here. We've got your beautiful wife, Margaret.
Hello.
Thank you guys for being here. What are you here to do today?
Well, we are here to present a check to ABET Projects.
Now, who's we? Now, IAP, explain
IAP
that a little bit.
IAP is a defense contractor. We provide services wherever our soldiers are located, or sailors or airmen, we are there. We provide base support services, information technology, power, you name it, we do it.
Now, Ulysses, this is Ulysses Shields from IAP Innovation and Purpose, right?
Innovation and Purpose, that is true.
Worldwide Services. Okay, so give a little bio on yourself, though, because other than what you're doing now for the troops, you yourself did a little tour of duty.
I did. I spent 25 years active duty, retired as a Chief Warrant Officer from the Army. Had a lot of fun, toured all over the world with a lot of different units. And now I have two sons that are in the military, one in the National Guard, and one is active duty Army stationed up at Fort Campbell.
Outstanding. And again, I just want all of our listeners to know that we do put the appeal out there for help, because you really do have to help us help them, meaning our military family. And IAP puts its money where its mouth is, and you guys had this awesome 5K this last November, and you were able to give back to AVET Project like $5,000. Tell us about this today.
Well, what we're going to do, this is, you know, IAP is actually committed to veteran programs, okay? What we have is a CEO who is a West Point grad. The Vice President of Operations is a West Point grad. And so when you look at within the organization, we have a lot of other academy grads from the Navy as well as the Air Force. And our intent is to make sure that whatever we do is with a full commitment to those services, to make sure that we are giving back. So we've done programs to give back to it. As a matter of fact, IAP's workforce is made up of approximately 32% veterans. And our goal in the next 3 years is to increase that to 35%. So
okay,
Ulysses,
tell me how somebody can find out about employment opportunities with IAP.
Well, all you have to do is go to www.iapws.com and go in and click on careers. We're there.
IAPWS, that's IAP Worldwide Services.com. Outstanding. Okay, so today, and again, we need help, people. AVET Project can't do this alone. Nobody makes a paycheck with AVET Project, and we need every dollar and every volunteer that we can get. And IAP, God bless you all for what you're doing, not just in hiring, recruiting, and retaining veterans in your workforce, but the fact that you're supporting AVET Project, particularly our PR&R program, Project Recuperation Reintegration Retreat for Returning Combat Vets, because this awesome donation, this grant that you're making to AVET Project today, is getting dedicated to that program. What are we doing here now?
Well, what I would like to do is present to you, on behalf of IAP, a check for
$5,000.
Wow, everybody, thank you so much. Okay, Glenn, I'm gonna turn it over to you, and Kim can get a picture of Ulysses handing this to me.
Okay. Starting at 1 o'clock again, 1 to 4:30 will be the air show. And while they're taking pictures over there, it's been passed over to me. And you heard the 100-year-old veteran, retired Air Force Lieutenant Colonel Dick Cole, who flew the B-25 with Jimmy Doolittle. And guess what? One of those B-25s is going to be flying out here today.
It's impressive. We're at the 39th annual Tico Warbird Air Show. And we're the WMEL American Warrior Radio Booth station right now. We're just by the information booth. If you're out here, we're planning on coming out. We're going to be here through the end of this episode. So come on by and say hello. There's so much going on. We've got car shows. We've got live fire exercises. All of the aircraft and everything else. And right now we're just, again, posing for the picture here, because IAP has been so generous in its support of AVET Project and what we do to help our military family. Ulysses, again, thank you so much, sir, for stopping by, for your service to our country, and for this incredible donation.
It is our pleasure, Garen, and we look forward to working with AVET well into the future.
Outstanding. One last time, website to get a hold of IAP.
IAP, www.iapws.com. airshow.com.
Outstanding. Thank you so much, sir. Really appreciate it. And Glenn, we got to keep rolling because we've got so much ground to cover here.
Rock and roll.
Yeah, well, we did our interview with Dick Cole. I hope you all enjoyed that. We've got Ulysses and Kristen Dunn with Ron Davis is here somewhere. Okay. And actually, I'm going to go over here right now because I want to introduce one of our next guests. Ron,
good to see you again.
Thank you for everything you're doing. Ulysses, come on over here. I want to introduce you real quick.
Ron Davis, how are you? I'm public relations director for this air show.
Great air show.
Well, thank you. Delighted that you had a chance to come and be part of it.
Thank you for the invite. I really appreciate it. So does IAP.
Wonderful.
And I want to also say, General Monty, 45th Space Command, we're going to have an interview with you here in a moment, sir, but thank you for being here.
Well, I really appreciate it, Jared. Wouldn't miss this. Great air show and a great way to kick off the air show season right here with your type of operators.
Outstanding. So stay tuned for that. We've got a little more to cover here in the first segment, but I want to just say to everybody, Ron Davis,
sir,
the Director
nice
of Communications for the Tycho Warburg Air Show. Ron, you made an awesome video kind of detailing what's going on here throughout the week. It actually started last night. Tell us a little about last night.
Well, it was the first time we ever tried an evening air show, and let me tell you, you want to talk something and knock your socks off. We had three acts that began flying about sundown. Two piston acts, a Beech-18 small transport flying with lights and sparklers, four T-6 aircraft flying formation, and a spectacular show by Randy Ball and his MiG-17, a 70-year-old design flying just below the speed of sound out here in front of us with a long flame out of the afterburner. People were just breathless. And we'll surely do that again, but here we're in a beautiful sunny day right here at the Space Coast Regional Airport. We're going to start flying, and it says here about an hour and a half, and we have phenomenal 3 hours of flying to show our guests, and we'd sure like anybody who's listening and hadn't made the decision to come out, show up here right now. Come see Fifi the B-29, come see this magnificent F-16 flying demonstration, our wonderful warbirds, the static displays, all our vendors, the carnival for the kids. We've got so darn much going on.
Okay, so we're running out of time in this first segment of American Warrior Radio, but don't go anywhere because we haven't even started yet. Ron, thank you so much for everything
you
do and for your service to our country. Really appreciate it, sir.
Thank you. It's a real privilege, and I sure love what I have to do now. Nice way for Granddaddy to have fun.
I guess so. Well, everybody, I know we're running low here. Glenn, anything you want to say?
Looking really forward to the interviews coming up, and if we have time, we're going to squeeze in Joanne Ivins, our director of counseling.
Joanne's on the on-deck circle, and it's going to be an abbreviated version of Journey of the Spirit, but don't go anywhere, people. American Warrior Radio on AM 1060 WBL is going to be right back after the break.